Now let's talk about layout. I'm going to start out by setting an auto layout with one photo per page for this book, and the first thing I'd like to change is the layout of the cover. To do that, I'll click on that cover, and then I'm going to use that right drop-down to select a new cover layout. Now I'd like to set the layout of the pages below. If I want to change all of them at the same time, all I need to do is select all of those pages by using the keyboard shortcut Command or Control A. Then I'll go over to the page panel, and I'm going to choose one of these options. If I want to change the layout of an individual page, I just click on that one page, and I can either use that page panel again, or I can use the drop-down just to the bottom right of that page and choose a different layout. As I'm going through these options, if I find one that I like and I want to make sure that I can access it quickly, I can toggle this button on the top right of that specific layout and it will add it to my favorites. Another thing I can do is customize a page and then save that so I can use it again. I'm going to select this page and then view this spread, and I'll just make some quick custom modifications to this page. I'll add some page text. And then I'll go into that cell panel and increase the padding of this image. If I turn off the Link All button, now I can adjust the padding on each individual side. I'm also going to highlight this text and give it a different style. I'll do that in the type setting. Now I'm ready to save this as a custom layout. To do that, I just right-click over that page and select Save as Custom Page. Now if I click on another page and go into Custom Pages, I can select that page from the list.